This is tonight's 9 at 9. A triple shooting on the city's south side leaves two people dead.
We spoke with the father of one of the men who died. He said he got a text from his son around 9 o'clock last night saying he was going to come see him at his house. He never showed up. Instead, his son came to River City Saloon.
Police say the situation started when a man got into a fight with the bar's security guard. Both pulled out guns and ended up killing each other. A third person was injured in that shootout. The Dallas judge who gave convicted murderer Amber Guyger a Bible accused of overstepping her authority. The Freedom From Religion Foundation says the judge's actions were inappropriate and unconstitutional. Meanwhile, the brother of the man Guyger killed spoke to ABC about why he chose to forgive her.
I didn't really plan on living the rest of my life, you know, hating this woman. That's the type of stuff you need to do to have peace of mind.
Guyger has begun her 10-year prison sentence.
The victim's family attorney says although they'd hope for a longer sentence, closer to the 28 years the prosecution had asked for, they still believe in the legal system.
Here at home,
a man is dead after police say he lost control of his motorcycle and crashed against a metal guardrail.
Police say the motorcyclist was speeding on Highway 90 when he tried to take the ramp to I-35. He was pronounced dead there at the scene. Protests that started months ago in Hong Kong over a proposed extradition bill are still going on.
This is becoming an increasingly familiar sight here in Hong Kong, an entrance to a subway in flames.
The government has banned protesters from wearing face masks while assembling, sparking more protests. Alleged drug smugglers off the coast of Colombia found using blocks of cocaine as life rafts after their boat sank. The three men were spotted about 30 miles offshore. The men were rescued but are now facing charges. Former Texas Governor Rick Perry reportedly plans to step down from his position as Energy Secretary by the end of the year. Perry has not confirmed his reported departure. Politico first reported the story, which was later picked up by the Washington Post, the New York Times, and CNN. Ohio University is suspending all 15 fraternities on its campus. This after it received several allegations of hazing this year, and less than a year ago, a freshman died while pledging. A Florida man sentenced to 10 years in jail after missing jury duty. He was sworn in as a juror on a civil case. He was supposed to return the next day, but he overslept.
I woke up and I looked at the time. I was like, oh shoot, it's past the time.
The man spent 10 days in jail, is on probation for a year, and has to complete 150 hours of community service. A satirical oil painting by anonymous British artist Banksy sold at auction for a record $12.2 million. The painting, Devolved Parliament, depicts the House of Commons filled with chimpanzees. The final sale price far exceeded auction house Sotheby's estimate. To read more about these nine stories, go to ksat.com/news at 9.